This video represents a mashup of two tasks, one in which a scout is encouraged to recycle old stuff, in this case, compact discs, and one in which a scout is called upon to make a festive holiday decoration. So, we're shooting for crafty and craftsy. 'Cause yes, the holidays are again upon us, and that often means overindulgences and excesses of all stripes. So bear that in mind as I demonstrate how to make a Christmas tree door decoration reusing old compact discs. You know, just because we can do something doesn't always mean we should. Now, I traditionally get hives whenever I'm within 50 yards of a Hobby Lobby store, but there's no getting out of the Big Scout project without wielding a glue gun. My eyes glazed at the possibilities within that place, but one look at those big foam boards and I settled on an idea for a Christmas tree decoration based on an idea I'd seen for a wreath. The board measured 40 by 32, and I used my trusty ruler to measure out the basic form for a tree. X-Acto knife in hand, I cut carefully around that outline, and in order to hang my decoration, I needed one more cut near the top through which a wreath hanger could fit. Now, we've got a green front door, so I opted for a red tree, and I think this choice concerned my husband unnecessarily, but he seems resigned to it now. And the entire thing painted bright red, I laid out the bottom layer of CDs, shiny side up, and fired up the glue gun for its maiden voyage. That's a fun little invention, isn't it? And I glued those bad boys in place and laid out a top layer of discs to add some dimension and depth to the tree. Setting up the battery-operated lights is where it gets really fun, though. I'd seen a wreath where the battery pack was actually glued to the back and the strings of lights glued onto the front. Now, I could have done this, but I thought that I might want to use those lights for other projects at some point. So I glued a baggie to the tree trunk on the back, and it works as a housing for the battery pack. And instead of gluing the strings of lights to the front of the tree, I used packing tape rather discreetly on the back of the discs along the side of the tree to secure the lights in place. Finally, I hung up the tree and disguised the hanger with a big old bow. Turn on the lights, and voila! Here's your tree. My camera couldn't get a good picture of it outside at night, but here's what it looks like by day. This was quick and easy, but again, I think this particular project falls under the category of just because you can do something doesn't mean you should. So I await public comment. Yes, it certainly represents the home of two musicians pretty well, and Lord knows it's visible from the street. But still, I don't know.